Now, about the most worrisome development I see among Zoomers in using computers is the fact that there are so many people who use, sometimes exclusively, cloud services to consume product, to do computing and stuff like that. What I mean is, people no longer even have files on their own computers. They don't have their own documents. They don't have their own pictures. They don't have their own music or movies. They don't have anything else. They use instead services like Google Drive, Facebook, Spotify, Netflix, all of these services through which they either put their data or they get data. And we're getting to the point where people don't really even have computers, okay? Really, they have small flash drives that are hooked up to a screen that have like basic system configuration, like your color theme and your user data, and then all of your actual data, all of your stuff is online, theoretically. Sometimes it's not even there, sometimes it's not even yours, okay? Now, why is this a problem? Now, I will say, it's mostly a problem for reasons you don't quite see if you're in this domain, because you just think of it as being, oh, I can just go online and get all my stuff. You don't realize all the things you could do with plain files on your computer. You can copy them on a USB, you can share them with friends, you can do all this kind of stuff. You can use, you know, Unix commands to do things programmatically to them. You can reorganize them, you can put them in the way you like, all these kind of things that you can do. Whereas people are now sort of plugged into these centralized systems, okay? And that's a big problem. First off, because, you know, if you put your pictures on Facebook, Facebook legally, I don't think it's officially they own your pictures, but they have legal rights to them, okay? And if anything goes wrong, if there's any kind of your data is compromised, it's just over. It's out of your control. You're utterly just having faith. You know, a lot of people will be very critical of these social media companies, and they still trust them with all of their data. Like, that's their primary place to keep data. Like, the best thing you can do right now is just close your Facebook account. They even allow you to download an archive of all your stuff. You don't even have to worry about it, so you can actually have it on your own computer, okay? So, the thing that's annoying to me, I mean, also in terms of, like, internet architecture, you have to think about how crazy inefficient this system is, this system of basically digital homelessness, where you don't even have property. That's the thing. Like, I've said before, people need to have their own internet property in terms of internet, but you also need your own local digital property. You need to be able to have your own files. That seems like a very basic thing. And you need that for reasons you don't even necessarily understand if you've just used cloud computing, because you don't even realize the programs you can use your stuff with. I mean, just as an example, a lot of normies out there use, of course, Netflix, okay? Netflix or Spotify to stream music and movies. And of course, first off, this is hugely inefficient on the internet, because what happens is if you watch a movie five times, you're downloading it five times, okay? Unless Netflix probably has a cache of something you've just watched. But in normal circumstances, like, the internet is, like, nowadays is mostly Netflix. Netflix and YouTube. And on YouTube's case, at least you're watching different videos, usually, unless you watch the same video over and over again. But in Netflix, a lot of times people are just re-downloading these massive gigabytes of movies. Same kind of thing on Spotify. But, you know, so people don't have the actual files. They can't just give it to people. They can't just give a movie file to people. Whereas people, old boomers like me, who still download music and movie files, I just have all that on my computer. First off, I can use them without the internet, okay? I literally, when I go on a airplane ride, I can literally open my laptop and watch a movie, okay? You know, just a cheap domestic flight where I don't have screens. I can just pull up my laptop. I can watch Star Wars, oh! Or something like that, okay, all right? Anything that I happen to have, okay? So I have, since, I guess I was around 18 or so, I just, whenever I watch a movie, I download it. There's no reason to stream it on some shady site or something like that, or use Netflix, because once I have that file, I can do whatever I want with it. I can give it to people, I can do whatever. Same thing is, there are also programs like, for example, Kodi. Maybe I should do a video on that, because it's sort of a normie-friendly program that I actually sometimes use. I'm ashamed to say that, but only when people are over at my house. Kodi is basically a program. If you have a bunch of movie files on your computer in a directory, you can say, hey, Kodi, look at this directory. And what it does is it automatically grabs, like, the images and the information about that movie, and it displays it in a thing that actually looks a lot like Netflix or one of those services, except for it's totally offline. You can use it you know, whenever you want. It's a very nice server. Actually, you can even put in plugins that, like, download movies and stuff like that, like, stream them from, like, I don't know, some kind of piracy service or something like that. But anyway, so that's the thing that I find very frustrating about other people's computer setups when I have to use them or I have to give recommendations, because a lot of people just don't think, like, they don't realize that, like, files are the things that you are most in control of. You can, when you have, like, a document on your computer, even if you're using Microsoft Word or something, that's much better than using something like Google Docs. If you use Google Docs, you have to be connected to the internet. Sure, there are ways to sync it up, but it's always some weird Google Docs file, it's just one of those things. You are dependent on this massive centralized structure to get a very basic level of computing done, okay? I want to be able to, if I'm in a city, if I have my laptop, I don't want to need internet 100% of the time. I want the ability to take my laptop on a bus and do work without having to worry about being connected to the internet. And so people will go, it's crazy nowadays how people will go to extreme lengths to, I gotta have my cell phone hotspot on and all this kind of stupid stuff when they don't need, like, if you just had the files, you wouldn't have to worry about it. And even more than that, okay, this is just me talking about sort of practical things. We're also getting to the point where, you don't have privacy, you don't have security, and I know that's an abstraction to people sometimes, because it's like, oh, they're not going to monitor me or something like that. The thing is, you never know what's going to happen, okay? The reality is, when you have files on someone else's computer, you don't even know what kind of, you know, when you're sending your files on Google's servers, you have no clue what they're running there, you have no clue what they're looking at. And you having that data there is a permanent liability, okay? You might even say, oh, I trust Google. Oh, man, Google's our greatest ally, blah, blah, blah. Okay, but in the future, things might change. And that data of yours is permanently out there. You don't know what they're doing with it, okay? You legitimately have no clue. It is a permanent liability. That's what I think people need to realize. It's not so much, you know, you're looking at these companies that you give data to, and you're saying, oh, they've done bad stuff, so I don't trust them. It's, I am giving them a massive opportunity to do bad stuff and have absolutely no recourse about it. That's the issue, okay? That's really the issue. Because there have been many services in the past, online services like this, that have compromised data, compromised passwords because they stored them in some stupid way, done lots of bad things, okay? Sometimes even just by negligence. And you are just setting yourself up for failure in doing that. It is much nicer... Okay, it's much nicer to just have these files on your computer. You can do lots of magical stuff. All the stuff that I talk about in my videos, when I'm like grepping stuff and setting stuff and looking at media info and arranging things in a particular order, all of that stuff I can do because I do locally. So, same thing with all my files, even my email, okay? Email is actually something that I think a lot of people don't even realize, but you should have all of your mail offline. Okay, this is my firm belief. Especially if you're using a service like Gmail or something like this. When I have to use Gmail for work, I've worked at jobs where I had a Gmail account. What I always do is I use iSync, which is a nice command line program that can download mail for you. It'll download mail if you give it your username, password, your setup or whatever. It will download mail to your computer. It'll log into that IMAP server and pull down your email. So you can actually look at it offline, and it even though you still have that email on your computer, you can put it, you know, back it up if you want to. I have all my emails from back when I was, you know, 16, okay? That is not touching the internet anymore, okay? So if Google servers get compromised, if some other servers get compromised, it's not an issue. Even if Google is snooping on you, whenever I have one of these accounts online, I only have like basically 5 emails online at a time before I go through them and get rid of them. Then I save them offline to an archive. So that's usually how I think. And now look at my situation. I think maybe people don't realize this because maybe I should do a video on it. But on my computer right now, okay, or on hard drives or things that are encrypted, I have all my music and movies, okay, that I can watch whenever, including some TV shows. I'm actually deleting all the TV shows and movies that are like cringe and blue-pilled, but, you know, I have most of them. I have all my mail I've ever gotten, okay? I have an offline store of that. All my images, all my text files, all like everything that I've ever written, you know, all that kind of stuff, easily searchable offline on my own computer. And we live in a period of massive amounts of data, or massive amounts of storage space. Like, it, you can get a terabyte drive. A terabyte is, like, I'm sorry, I'm a boomer. That used to be a massive amount, and it still is. But you can get a terabyte drive for under $100. Under $100, okay? Basically, every computer, I don't know, it's just crazy how much space they have nowadays. So, anyway, that's the thing I'm most worried about now, is that people are moving to a state where all computers have to be used tethered to some online service. It's a way of keeping you locked in to Google or Apple or any of this kind of stuff. And sure, they offer conveniences. Oh, wow, Google Drive syncs my stuff so I can access it on multiple computers. Okay, that's cool. So does the USB drive. There's lots of free software that does that. You can run locally on your own computer and it syncs up, you know, sync thing I've done a video on. You can learn how to use Git if you're using text files. You can learn how to use rsync. There are many other, there are things like OneDrive. What's the other one that's like OneDrive? Some other kind of drive, Nextcloud, something like that, I forget, whatever, but there are lots of services like that that are just like Google Drive that you can host. You basically still have your files, okay, and it's not in some goofy Google Drive format or something like that. So that's just one thing, and I'm just saying this, like, I'm not telling you to just massively change the way you do computing, but just think about that when you start doing new things. It's better to have things offline, but back in the day, I actually used, this is cringe, now I'm just sort of actually rambling, but back in the day, before I got red-pilled on anything technology-related, I literally used to be the guy who kept everything on Google Drive, okay? I just had everything. I even kept a little offline store of them on my computers, you know, I had it sync locally, but, yeah, that's not the same thing. It really just isn't. Yeah, I was, like, really cringe back in the day. Like, I don't know. The reason I complain about all this kind of stuff in computers is mostly because I've done it when I was a dumb kid. Anyway. So, yeah, that's about it. Whatever. See you guys next time.